understand chapter 12 module 2 the muscular system and digestive system in human beings. In the previous module we have studied about muscular system. In this module we will study about digestive system. Students, conversion of food into soluble form and its absorption into the blood is called digestion. I repeat, conversion of food into a soluble form and its absorption into the blood is called digestion. The digestive system consists of alimentary canal and digestive glands. I repeat, the digestive system consists of the alimentary canal and digestive glands. The total length of alimentary canal is about 9 meters. Its main parts are the mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and anus. I repeat, its main parts are mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and anus. The salivary glands, liver, and pancreas are the digestive glands connected to the alimentary canal. I repeat, the salivary glands, liver, and pancreas are the digestive glands connected to the alimentary canal. Different organs of the digestive system systematically perform the function of digestion. There are different stages in the process of digestion of the food, and at each stage there is a different organ of the digestive system which perform its specific role. I repeat, there are different stages in this process of digestion of the food, and at each stage there is digestion different organ of the digestive system which performs its specific role. Students, now let us understand about teeth. The process of digestion begins with the function of the teeth in the mouth. There are four types of teeth, namely incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Each type of tooth has a specific function. Each tooth is covered by a hard substance called enamel. Enamel is made up of a calcium salt. Repeat, each tooth is covered by a hard substance called enamel. Enamel is made up of a calcium salt. Students, saliva contains an enzyme called ptyalene or salivary amylase. Ptyalene converts starch into a sugar called maltose. Enzymes are substances secreted in the body of an organism which bring about specific chemical reactions. They act as catalysts. I repeat, enzymes are substances secreted in the body of an organism which bring about specific chemical reactions. They act as catalysts. Digestive enzymes of the digestive system bring about changes in the food materials. As you can see, children, carbohydrates are converted to the glucose with the help of enzymes like amylase, maltase, lactase. All these are different enzymes. Metabolic processes are impossible without enzymes. I repeat, metabolic processes are impossible without enzymes. Enzymes are a specific type of proteins. They are most active at normal body temperature. I repeat, enzymes are a specific type of proteins. They are most active at normal body temperature. Students, now let us understand the different parts of digestive system. First, let us begin with mouth. Digestion of food begins in the mouth. Food is chewed with the help of teeth into very small pieces. Next is salivary glands. Saliva is produced in the salivary glands in the mouth cavity located in front of ears, near the pharynx and below the tongue. I repeat, saliva is produced in the salivary glands in the mouth cavity located in front of the ears, near the pharynx and below the tongue. It is carried to the mouth via ducts. It is mixed with food during the process of chewing. Students, pharynx or throat. Next is pharynx or throat. The esophagus and trachea open into the pharynx. I repeat, the esophagus and trachea open into the pharynx. Next is esophagus. It is a tube leading from the pharynx to the stomach. It pushes the food. Next are the pancreas. The pancreas secretes the pancreatic juice that contains various enzymes. I repeat, the pancreas secretes the pancreatic juice that contains various enzymes. Next comes to the liver. Students, the liver is the largest gland in the body. It has a rich supply of blood. Its main function is storage of glucose. The gallbladder is situated below the liver. Liver stores the bile, the digestive juice secreted by the liver. While bile is carried into the small intestine, it mixes with the food there and helps in digestion of fats. I repeat, it stores the bile, the digestive juice secreted by the liver. When bile is carried into the small intestine, it mixes with the food there and helps in digestion of fats. Bile contains bile salts. Now next, let us understand about the stomach. Students, the large sac-like part of the alimentary canal is called the stomach. The gastric glands of stomach secrete gastric juice. Repeat, the large sac-like part of the alimentary canal is called the stomach. The gastric glands of stomach secrete gastric juice. Food that has entered stomach is chewed three components of gastric juice, namely hydrochloric acid, pepsin, and mucus are mixed with food here and it becomes acidic. Mainly, proteins are digested in the stomach. Due to the churning and the action of gastric juice, food becomes a semi-solid slurry which is slowly pushed into the small intestine. I repeat, mainly proteins are digested in the stomach. Due to churning and the action of gastric juice, food becomes a semi-solid slurry which is slowly pushed into the small intestine. Now next we will understand about the small intestine. Students, the small intestine is about 6 meter long. Most of the digestion and absorption of food take place here. I repeat, the small intestine is about 6 meter long. Most of the digestion and absorption of food take place here. Three different digestive juices are mixed with the food in the small intestine. Absorption into the blood of nutrients obtained by the digestion of food also occurs in the small intestine. I repeat, three different digestive juices are mixed with the food in the small intestine. Absorption into the blood of nutrients obtained by the digestion of food also occurs in the small intestine. Now next, let us understand about the large intestine. Students, the large intestine is about 1.5 meter long. Only water is absorbed in the small intestine. The small part called the appendix is attached to the first part of the large intestine. Undigested remains of the food digested in the small intestine enter the large intestine. Students, undigested material is thrown out of the body through anus. I repeat, undigested material is thrown out of the body through the anus. Now let us understand some important glands of the digestive system, their secretion and functions. Let us take the first organ, that is mouth. Gland is salivary gland. It secretes saliva, that is saline, whose function is conversion of starch into maltose. Next organ is stomach. Gland is gastric wall. It secretes gastric juices like hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. Functions are to make food acidic, breakdown of proteins, to protect the inner lining of the stomach from hydrochloric acid. Next gland is liver. It secretes bile, whose function is to make food alkaline and to convert large fat particles into small ones. That is emulsification of fats. Next is pancreas. It secretes pancreatic juice, that is trypsin, lipase, amylase. Its function is to convert proteins into amino acids, to convert fats into fatty acids and glycerol, to convert complex carbohydrates into simple sugar. Next organ is small intestine. It secretes intestinal juice. Functions are to convert proteins into amino acids, to convert complex carbohydrates into glucose, to convert fats into fatty acids and glycerol. Students, are we putting our health at risk? Let us see how. Students, physical health is extremely important in personality development. When all our organ system function properly, we say that we are in good health. However, harmful habits like smoking, chewing of tobacco, drinking alcohol affect our health adversely. I repeat, however, harmful habits like smoking, chewing of tobacco, drinking alcohol affect our health adversely. Students, if we consume any tobacco products, the mouth, pharynx, alimentary canal, and other organs of the digestive system cannot function properly. I repeat, if we consume any tobacco products, the mouth, pharynx, alimentary canal, and other organs of the digestive system cannot function properly. Besides, tobacco particles stick to the teeth, gums, and skin of the mouth cavity and slowly cause injury to those parts, resulting in their dysfunction. The pharynx and intestine become inflamed, and the condition further progresses into cancer, leading to death. So students, what is our role? Making pictures and slogans against tobacco consumption, smoking, drinking alcohol, etc. and displaying them in the classroom and the neighborhood. Keeping a watch on whether one's surrounding are tobacco free. Composting an oath against addiction and taking the oath in the class and also during assembly. Making parents and teachers aware of such instances in the neighborhood. Now next, let us see points to remember. Conversion of food into a soluble form and its absorption into the blood is called digestion. The salivary glands, liver, and pancreas are the digestive glands connected to the alimentary canal. The large intestine is about 1.5 meter long. The pancreas secretes the pancreatic juice that contains various enzymes. There is a short homework for you. Name the different types of teeth. What is the function of each type? Write the effects of tobacco, alcohol, smoking on the digestive system. What are enzymes? What is the function of liver? Thank you.